In the request made to the Parliamentary Committee of National Economy, the State Minister for Finance in charge of general duties, Henry Musasizi, revealed that the loan would be drawn from the coffers of the International Development Association of the World Bank Group to finance the investment for industrial transformation and employment project.
To allow the government to borrow up to special drawing rights, 68.6 million and equivalent of 96 million, and receive a grant of special drawing rights, 74.3 million, amount an equivalent of 104 million.
Of this project worth $218 million, $150 million is to fund an evolving fund for agro-industrialists, manufacturers and exporters by providing low-cost credit to manufacturers whose products serve the export or local market.
Enhance economic transformation, create jobs and raise incomes. Unless strategically arrested, the economic shock emanating from COVID-19 will foment increasing spatial inequalities and further decreasing Uganda's competitive advantages.
While justifying this loan request to the committee, Musasizi noted that it's a magic bullet to fight poverty, which has increased due to COVID-19.
Investment supported under the project will have substantial impact on employment, either through creation of new wage paid positions or through value addition and manufacturing that will increase the quality and the quantity of jobs.
Legislators strongly opposed the move, reasoning that there is no urgency that would necessitate this approval. Legislators were vehemently opposed to the request, quoting the worsening of the public debt.
This loan here that is coming before us, it is not urgent and it is not important at this time.
This money would be good for an agricultural bank, but now you want to call it revolving fund. Chair, me, I will reject it on that basis.
I'm wondering, you are not telling us the manufacturers, you are not telling us how you are going to improve the employment, the magic bullet that you are going to use. All your projects before, when you are requesting for a loan, has been targeting the same use, the same statistics.
We need 90 years to repay this money. That is if we are not going to borrow any other money. We need 90 years as the people of Uganda to pay this money.
Musasizi insisted on justifications of the loan request that the said monies under the Invite Project will enable the government to help develop the economy from the adverse effects of COVID-19.
This is coupled with challenges related to reducing poverty, achieving inclusive growth and wealth creation. These challenges have been characterized into five development issues associated with low private sector growth and job creation in Uganda.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.